saving the best for last, the crankshaft pulley. Here we have this pulley here, also called a harmonic balancer, vibration damper, vibration balancer. It's a three-piece component. You have an inner metal hub, you have the elastomer, the rubber piece in the middle, then you have the outer ring, which has the grooves that drives your accessory belts. So this guy goes to the front of the crankshaft this way. Well, there's something missing there, but it's got some heft to it, and I'll try to guess, because that's what we've been doing all along. I'm gonna go with 7.5, maybe 7. Weight can be a little tricky to estimate because of, depends on the configuration of the component you're holding, right? So, well, let's just see. Okay. 6.8 pounds is what we have here. And actually, before all this, let me go and get a different one. I do have others that I'd like to look at. For example, I worked on a few VK45DEs in my day. So here we go. Here's a, this one's a little different. It's got two dimples on it. And it's going to be a good comparison. Let's look at this one as well. Oh, well, there you go. Two dimples as well. But then you'll notice that compared to this one here, I'm looking at this locator pin, and this one here, this counterbalance is 1, 2 holes over. This one here is only 1 hole over, right? Then the balance weight, the dimples, these two dimples are at like 3 o'clock versus this one here at 6 o'clock. Well, let me just take this one here and actually do a little more comparison. So you'd assume that since this one has less weight drilled from it, it's got fewer holes. That means it's got less weight taken away from it. It should be just a little heavier. So 6.8 pounds. Let's see how much this one weighs. Well, 6.8. So I don't blame it. The accuracy of my scale is only 0.2 pounds. So this is like grams taken away. So it's not going to show up. But you do notice that they're, as much as they are similar in weight, there's a little difference in configuration. So normally the video should end right here, but I decided to court some controversy, so this is what we're gonna do. The reason these pulleys are different is because each crank pulley is tuned to the crankshaft, to the engine in which it is installed. Because of the weight of the crankshaft, the length of the crankshaft, the stroke, you know, how much you have from the middle point of the crankshaft to the journals, right? And the material the crankshaft is made of, you know, how it was made. Is it cast? Is it forged? Those all determine what kind of vibration characteristics the engine will have, right? You do have, in place of a flywheel for manual transmissions, you have a torque converter for the automatic. And you do have quite a little bit of weight over here. So the controversial part of all of this is people that get aftermarket pulleys, lightweight pulleys, underdrive pulleys, whatever your reason. I'm not saying don't do it. I'm just saying there are things that you might need to take into consideration, especially if you're using this as a passenger car, because V8s in general are not as well balanced as inline sixes, for example. So the mini explosions that you have as a result of, you know, spark and ignition, you know, it's going to cause a little bit of vibration. So being that the VK45DE mainly came in luxury vehicles, Q45, M45, FX45, right? You do have some NVH considerations, noise, vibration, and harshness. It will sound very unsettling if you don't have a good harmonic balance setup going on. And two, you might actually, the crankshaft is actually pretty good. I think they're pretty robust. It's just that these engines have shown to be very finicky when you start messing with their rod bearings. Well, especially if you add oil, neglecting oil maintenance. So, but that's a topic for a different day. So it's mainly luxury motor, not exactly Lexus quiet or Lexus smooth, but it is pretty good for what it is. By the way, I usually like that. I feel like it's one of the best engineered Nissan engines, right? In my experience, for 4.5 liter V8 doesn't even come with like an oil cooler or anything, which might be something worth looking into, because the only thing that's wrong with these engines maybe is the oil. Eventually they consume and you just have to find a way to not neglect it. So I think it's, as I said, it's something that you need to take into consideration. I feel like sometimes, just because things are available, some people just buy aftermarket pulleys off the shelf and just slap them onto their engines and just keep going. And, you know, things could happen. So I'm not saying that I'm an authority in this subject. Yes, I did do enough coursework to attain a mechanical engineering degree. And I actually took a course on vibrations, but I just haven't dealt with it enough in my career to be able to design a proper pulley for you. I can design one that is statically balanced and also maybe dynamically balanced on the first order, but it's just different things that we consider. So there, it's not just about mass, it's not just about diameter. There are things that you take into account. When you have questions, personally, when I have questions about how something is supposed to work, especially for something as crucial as your crankshaft, usually I defer to the people that made the engine. These people have the time, resources, and experience, right? So they have thrown, be it hundreds of thousands or even millions of, let's go with dollars, but it works in any currency. They've thrown so much money into the design and research of this, and you can just machine something and slap it on and say it's fine. Because I usually say fitment does not equal good design. Yes, you could machine something out of all billet, because that's what, you know, looks good and people like that. Hey, it's all metal, look at that, it's billet, this and that. And it works and it does drive belts, but depending on what operational parameters you're doing, you might end up obviously with issues with accessories running properly or efficiently. Your alternator, your AC compressor, your water pump, it's belt driven in this car, you know. Power steering, those things might get affected if you use the wrong pulley. You might get imbalance, you know, which on the nicer end just causes chatter or belt jumping on your accessories, but on the worst end is causing something bad to happen to your crankshaft, right? Because this thing, as heavy and as rigid as it looks, it actually does flex quite a bit. You know, so I haven't done the analysis to tell you how much it is. All I just know is respect things. However, I'm not saying no to all aftermarket crank pulleys. There are companies out there that actually design things, and an aftermarket pulley could actually be way more expensive with this. If you think this is expensive, you need to find a properly designed aftermarket pulley to see what happens. So, but they usually, you know, depending on what it is you want to do, do you want to damp it for luxury? Do you want to damp it for racing? Do you want to damp it for durability? You know, it depends on what your goal is. And most of us don't have the resources to do that. So even if I bought the most expensive harmonic balancer, I need to actually find someone to tune it to my specific engine. I can't just pull it one M45 and slap it onto another M45 and say we're good, right? Yes, it might work, but it's just not proper design. And at that point, why did you pay so much money? Just go with a stock one, right? So this video is a little longer than I anticipated. I'm just kind of talking off the cuff here. But I just wanted to bring that into, you know, call that to attention. I do know these things are out there. You can research under drive pulleys all day long. But for people that gain some of the automotive exposure through my videos, you know, might be something worth talking about. Because people do ask me sometimes, should I do this? And there are reasons to not do these things. And I don't want to just sound like I'm always against modification. It's just that you have to do it with sense. No need to modify something that doesn't give you any value, no performance gain, and costs way too much money, right? So if at the end of the video we agree to disagree on our opinions, at least you know how much the stock one weighs. So 6.7 pounds is a starting point, right? So that's just my opinion on all this. And anyway, 6.7 pounds is all we're going to go with, okay? That's the best way I can end this video.